for nothing when it came to the love of the country. When most women were denied even basic education and stayed at home locked up within the four walls of the house, she was one of those who paid heed to the call for protest against the British Raj and mobilized women folks to join the Quit India movement. Though this protest was to be an orderly withdrawal of British from India, the British were on their heel to suppress it by force. Today, we are going to know about that patriot whose name remains forgotten in the pages of history of independence movement. It is Tara Rani Srivastava. The year was 1942, while World War II was tearing the world piece by piece as the major world powers were running the race to gain control over the world. India was running her own battle internally. The British wanted India to support them in the war, but were denied by the Indian National Congress. It was on August 8th, Mahatma delivered his famed Do or Die speech at the Golia Tank Maidan, declaring the launch of the Quit India movement. The mass protest was to initiate an orderly withdrawal of the British from India. The British were on their heels to suppress India. Majority of Indian leaders were put in prison without any trial. Harsh. After the speech of Mahatma to prevent their contact with the masses. On the other hand, thousands and thousands of Indians marched to the streets in protest against this act in support of Quit India movement with burning desire for freedom. Many women participated in this protest. Most of them weren't women who came from elite backgrounds or had degrees to boast of. They were ordinary women with no formal education or very little schooling. They grew up in poverty-stricken and conservative homes and yet decided to get involved in the struggle with an unmatched spirit and commitment. Tara Rani was one among those thousands who were into the rebellion against the British Raj. Tara Rani Srivastava was born in Saran, a place near the city of Patna, Bihar. Young Tara married Pulintu Babu at an early age. Srivastava and her husband were very passionate about the independence struggle and with a burning desire to do their part towards the cause. On August 12, 1942, the just married couples stood in front of the crowd and raised slogans against the British. They were leading a march in Sivan towards the police station. This act was seen as a major defiance by the British government. Their objective was to assert the power of unified India against the British by hoisting the tricolor on the roof of the police station. The police tried to cripple the protest and resorted to a show of physical force. The protesters were subject to lethal charge. When even the sticks failed to break the spirit, the police opened fire. Pulintu Babu was among the shot and wounded. After bandaging Babu's wounds with strips of cloth torn from her sari, Tara Rani nonetheless continued to march, where she attempted to hoist the flag. On her return, she found that her husband was no more. On 15th August 1942, a prayer meeting was held in Chapra in honor of her husband's sacrifice for the country. Even after the tragic loss of her husband, she continued to be a part of the freedom struggle until the partition of India on 15th August 1947. She was one of the many unsung women of the freedom struggle who dedicated their lives and put the motherland before their grief. They were the revolutionaries who fought all odds for the freedom of this great country. Vande Mataram. Thank you.
mataram